Palms growing in Florida landscapes are subject to a number of potentially serious nutrient deficiencies. Nutrient deficiencies are more easily prevented than corrected once they occur. Correction of nutrient deficiencies can take as long as 2 or 3 years for some elements. I'm Dr. DeBosque, and this video will discuss several of the most common nutritional deficiencies in palms and how to manage them. The most common deficiencies in palms are magnesium, manganese, potassium, boron, iron, and nitrogen, but we will talk in more detail about the first four. For fact sheets that include symptoms and management, visit EDIS at the web address shown on the page. Note that turfgrass and broadleaf plants are susceptible to some of the same nutrient deficiencies as palms in Florida landscapes. Any fertilizer that provides sufficient nutrients for palms will also provide sufficient nutrients for turfgrass and broadleaf plants. This not only simplifies fertilization by having to use only a single product, but eliminates a serious problem encountered when high nitrogen turf fertilizers are applied to turf areas with palms growing nearby. Roots of large palms typically extend out 50 feet or more from the trunk in all directions and will take up whatever fertilizers have been applied to the turf grass. The high nitrogen to potassium ratio and the lack of any magnesium in most turf fertilizers forces rapid growth in palms, but without sufficient potassium or magnesium to support that growth, this growth dilutes the existing potassium and magnesium reserves within the palm and induces or exacerbates potassium and or magnesium deficiencies in the palms. Potassium deficiency symptoms vary among species, but always appear first on the oldest leaves. Older leaflets of some palms are mottled with yellow spots that are translucent when viewed from above. In other palms, symptoms appear on older leaves as marginal or tip necrosis with little or no yellowish spotting present. Potassium deficiency is caused by insufficient potassium in the soil, but can be induced or accentuated by high nitrogen to potassium or calcium to potassium ratios in the soil. Potassium is readily leached from sand or limestone soils, which have very low cation exchange capacities. Potassium deficiency is very common on palms grown in highly leached sandy soils. It is less common in container substrates. Potassium deficiency is perhaps the most widespread of all palm nutrient deficiencies. Visual symptoms alone may be sufficient for diagnosis of this disorder, although leaf nutrient analysis may be helpful in distinguishing late-stage potassium deficiency from manganese deficiency. Regular applications of potassium fertilizers will prevent potassium deficiency and treat palms already deficient. On sandy soils or those having little cation exchange capacity, controlled release potassium sources are much more effective than the easily leached water-soluble potassium sources. Sulfur-coated potassium sulfate has been shown to be the most effective and economical source of potassium in the landscape. For mild to moderately potassium deficient palms, application of a controlled release 8-12-4 magnesium palm maintenance fertilizer every 3 months should be sufficient to treat and prevent potassium deficiencies. Treatment of potassium deficient palms may require 1 or 2 years or longer, since the entire canopy of the palm may need to be replaced with new symptom-free leaves. Removal of discolored older potassium deficient leaves on a regular basis has been shown to accelerate the rate of decline from this disorder and can result in premature death of the palm. Severely potassium deficient palms should be fertilized with a no nitrogen, no phosphorus controlled release palm fertilizer such as 00166 magnesium plus micronutrients instead of the 8-12-4 magnesium material for the first two applications, but subsequent fertilization should be with the 8-12-4 magnesium material. Magnesium deficiency appears on the oldest leaves of palms as broad chlorotic bands along the margins of the central portion of the leaves remaining distinctly green. In severe cases, only the rachis and adjacent portions of the leaflets remain green on the oldest leaves, but younger leaves show progressively wider bands of green along the centers of leaves. In date palms, leaflet tips on the oldest leaves may be necrotic, but this necrosis is due to potassium deficiency superimposed on magnesium deficient leaves. Where the two deficiencies coexist on the same palm, the oldest leaves will show typical potassium deficiency symptoms, while magnesium deficiency symptoms will be visible on mid-canopy leaves. Transitional leaves will have potassium deficiency symptoms on the distal portion of the leaf, while magnesium chlorosis will be seen on the basal leaflets. In fan palms with deeply dissected leaves, the chlorosis may appear as broad yellow bands along the margins of individual leaflets. Magnesium deficiency can be fatal in palms. Magnesium deficiency is caused by insufficient magnesium in the soil. High levels of nitrogen, potassium, or calcium in the soil can also induce or exacerbate magnesium deficiencies. Magnesium deficiency is very common on highly leached soils in Florida. It can also occur in container-grown palms if dolomitic limestone has not been added to the substrate. Also, since palms may remain in a container for up to a year or longer, any added dolomite is usually exhausted after 6 months or so, with magnesium deficiency symptoms becoming visible as a result. Most species of palms are susceptible to magnesium deficiency to some degree, but Canary Island date palm is by far the most susceptible species to this disorder. Visual symptoms alone are usually sufficient to diagnose magnesium deficiency, although leaf nutrient analysis can also be helpful. Magnesium deficiency is difficult to correct once symptoms are present. In container-grown palms, it is best prevented by amending all container substrates with 12 to 15 pounds of dolomite per cubic yard. For palms in landscapes and field nurseries in areas prone to magnesium deficiency, magnesium should be included in all fertilizers in a controlled release form. On acid soils, dolomite or magnesium oxide can be used as controlled release magnesium sources, but on neutral to alkaline soils, prilled kieserite is an excellent controlled release source. Treatment of severely deficient palms can require 1 to 2 years or more and is accomplished by broadcasting magnesium sulfate, preferably in the less soluble prilled kieserite form, at rates of 2 to 5 pounds per tree, 4 to 6 times per year, to the area under the canopy. This treatment should be considered as a supplement to regular applications of a balanced 8-to-12-4 magnesium palm maintenance fertilizer. To reduce the potential of salt injury, magnesium and maintenance fertilizer applications can be offset by 6 weeks. The newest leaves of manganese-deficient palms emerge chlorotic with longitudinal necrotic streaks. As the deficiency progresses, newly emerging leaflets appear necrotic and withered on all but basal portions of the leaflets. This withering results in a curling of the leaflets about the rachis, giving the leaf a frizzled appearance. Within a single leaf, manganese deficiency symptoms are concentrated at the base of the leaf and are less severe or non-existent towards the tip. On new leaves of manganese-deficient coconut palm, necrotic leaflet tips fall off and the leaf has a singed appearance. In severely manganese-deficient palms, growth stops and newly emerging leaves consist solely of necrotic petiole stubs. Palm death usually follows. Although the symptoms described above develop only on newly expanding leaves, the presence of symptomatic leaves lower in the canopy is an indication that manganese deficiency has occurred in the past. Manganese deficiency is caused by insufficient manganese in the soil or by high soil pH, which greatly reduces manganese availability. In soils where manganese is marginally sufficient, cold soil temperatures may cause temporary manganese deficiency by reducing root activity levels. This is particularly common on coconut palm in Florida. Composted sewage sludge and manure products have also been shown to strongly bind manganese when used as fertilizers or as soil amendments for palms. Manganese deficiency is very common on alkaline soils, but can occur in containers if drainage is poor or soil temperatures are cool. Most species of palms can be effective, but queen, royal, paratus, pygmy date, and African oil palms are particularly susceptible. Visual symptoms may be sufficient to diagnose this disorder, but leaf nutrient analysis is also suggested, since symptoms of iron and potassium deficiencies can be similar. Late-stage potassium deficiency symptoms are virtually indistinguishable from those of manganese deficiency at a distance, and close examination is required to look for characteristic longitudinal streaking and basal symptom distribution of manganese deficiency. Fertilizers containing water-soluble manganese should be used routinely on soils where manganese deficiency is a problem. Although soil applications of manganese sulfate are effective, spraying the foliage with this product may achieve more rapid those short-term results, especially on alkaline soils. This should be considered as a supplement to soil applications, not as a replacement. Manganese sulfate solutions to be applied to the foliage can be made by mixing 3 pounds of this product in 100 gallons of water. Soil application rates are dependent on palm species, soil type, and severity of manganese deficiency. These rates will range from as low as 8 ounces for a small palm, or one growing on an acid sand soil, to 8 pounds for a large palm growing on a limestone soil. broadcast this product over the soil under the palm canopy. Applications can be repeated every 2 to 3 months, depending on the severity of the problem and soil type. However, response may not be seen until 3 to 6 months after applications. Avoid using composted sewage sludge or manure products near palms. Excessive manganese applications normally result in an induced iron deficiency with this characteristic new leaf chlorosis. Boron deficiency results in a wide array of symptoms, not only among species of palms, but also within a single species. Symptoms always occur on newly emerging leaves, but remain visible on these leaves as they mature and are replaced by younger leaves. One of the earliest symptoms of boron deficiency on areca palm and queen palm is transverse translucent streaking on the leaflets. In many species, mild boron deficiency can be manifested as sharply bent leaflet tips, commonly called hook leaf. These sharp leaflet hooks are quite rigid and cannot be straightened without tearing the leaflets. Temporary shortage of boron can cause a series of inverted V-shaped truncations of each leaf to occur. One of the most common symptoms of boron deficiency is the failure of newly emergent spear leaves to open normally. They may be tightly fused throughout the entire length, or the fusion can be restricted to basal or distal parts of the spear leaf. Perhaps the most unusual symptoms of chlorotic boron deficiency is the tendency for the entire crown to bend in one direction. This is one form of epinasty that can also cause twisting of petioles and leaves or sharp bends to the petiole, resulting in a single new leaf growing downward along the trunk. Boron deficiency in its acute form produces yet other symptoms. Often leaves emerge greatly reduced in size and crumpled in a corrugated fashion. Palms often grow out of these symptoms, but the deficiency may kill the meristem. Boron deficient palms often abort their fruits prematurely and inflorescences may have extensive necrosis near the tips. These symptoms are very similar to those of lethal yellowing in species affected by that disease. The calyx end of fallen coconuts from lethal yellowing infected coconut palm will be blackened, whereas coconuts from boron deficient trees will not have this blackened end. Boron deficiency is caused by insufficient boron in the soil. Boron is readily leached through most soils, with a single heavy rain event temporarily leaching most available boron out of the root zone. When this leaching stops, boron released from decomposing organic matter will again provide adequate boron for normal palm growth in most cases. Boron deficiency is also common in deserts and seasonally dry areas where soil drying tightly binds boron. Chronic boron deficiency is believed to be caused by soil drying and high soil pH, while temporary boron deficiency is caused by heavy leaching. Boron deficiency is very widespread on palms growing in wet climates throughout the world, but can also occur in desert climates. Boron deficiency has been observed in container-grown palms, especially in seedlings. Boron deficiency symptoms are quite distinctive and are usually sufficient for diagnosis by themselves. Because boron deficiency is often very transient in nature, the element is immobile within the palm, and deficiencies affect only leaf primordia developing within the bud area. Leaf analysis is not particularly useful. Because the difference between deficiency and toxic levels of boron within plants is rather small, extreme caution should be exercised when applying boron fertilizers. Recommended landscape maintenance fertilizers typically contain 0.10% to 0.15% boron, and that appears to be sufficient to prevent boron deficiencies in most cases. One product, Granubore, has a longevity of about 3 months, making it suitable for blending with other slow-release fertilizers that have similar longevities. Its granular form also prevents it from settling out in mixed fertilizers. Current recommendations for correcting boron deficiencies in palms are intentionally conservative because of the potential for toxicity. Dissolve about 2 to 4 ounces of solubor or borax in 5 gallons of water and drench this into the soil under the canopy of a single palm. Do not attempt to apply dry boron fertilizers to the soil because turf grass or other ground covers in contact with it may be killed. Do not repeat this for at least 5 months because it will take this long to see the results of the first application. When it comes to treating severe palm deficiencies, the customer needs to know that the results will not be immediate and they need to be patient. Micronutrient deficiencies such as manganese and boron may not show recovery until new leaves emerge from the bud 4 to 6 months after treatment. Elimination of macronutrient deficiencies such as potassium and magnesium will require replacement of the entire canopy, a process that can take from 1 to 2 years or more. In this video, hopefully you can recognize the symptoms of potassium, magnesium, manganese, and boron deficiencies so that you can successfully treat or prevent them in the future.